In early 2018, while living in a pretty remote part of China, I was detained and interrogated for over 2 weeks under the suspicion of being a spy. This is a true story, I promise. The part about being interrogated, not about being a spy. During this time, I had all of my electronic devices confiscated and presumably scanned, copied, and who knows what else. When they finally released me, kicked me out of the country, and returned most of my devices, I had to decide exactly how I was going to handle these compromised pieces of tech. Perhaps a foreign government hasn't gotten a hold of your device yet. But I've received countless emails from people all around the world who fear that their device has been compromised in some way by an ex-boyfriend, a spouse, or even an employer. And even if that doesn't describe you, it's not a bad idea to do periodic checks and scans of your personal devices as a precautionary measure. And today we're going to walk through the checklist that I used after my experience in China to examine a mobile device and troubleshoot any issues that I had. Watch through and then be sure to download my full checklist here at allthingssecured.com/mobile-scan-checklist. In the event that your device is possibly compromised like mine was, the first thing I did was reset every single password. Yes, it was a pain, but it's absolutely essential. It's likely that whoever had access to your device could also have your credentials, and that's simply not a risk you want to take. Use a password manager if you aren't already, and make sure your new passwords are long, unique, and complex. After that, I added or changed my two-factor authentication, or 2FA, wherever possible. Why? Because even if somebody has my password, they still need either my authenticator codes or my security key to get into various accounts, and I want to make sure that all of my accounts are protected with 2FA. If you want to walk through on how to set up 2FA, I've got a separate video for you that you can see here or link to below. These are drastic measures that aren't necessary when you're doing just periodic checks. But if you think your device has been compromised in any way, this is the first place that you need to start. Now, onto what I think is a critical step, scanning your device for malware. And I want to show you exactly how I do it, and this is where Certo comes in, which I personally used on my iPhone after my experience in China, and I asked them to sponsor this video. Unlike other apps that you download on the App Store, Certo doesn't operate under the same sandbox restrictions. This means that it can thoroughly scan your phone's backup, not just the surface level files. To do this, you create an account with Certo. You're gonna download the anti-spy software on your computer, all right? And you can do that pretty easily through their download portal, and then physically connect your phone with a cable. It's in this way that Certo is able to scan the entire device to let you know if and how that device has been compromised. It takes a few minutes, which I'm gonna fast forward through here.
A few moments later.
The end result is a full analysis of the health of your device that offers a whole lot of peace of mind, I promise you that. Certo specializes in detecting spyware, keyloggers, and jailbreaking that can otherwise fly under the radar, and it is constantly being updated as new threats arise. Trust me, this tool is incredibly effective, especially if you suspect a more advanced type of spyware that might have been installed on your device. They also have an Android app, so go ahead and check that out if you're not an iPhone user. It's critical that you use a reputable app like Certo because not all spyware apps are created equal. Now, this is already a great value in my opinion, but I've worked with the Certo team to offer an additional 10% off when you use this link. So check out their website, go give it a try for yourself by going to certosoftware.com/allthingssecured. Next up, it's time to review all the apps installed on your device. If you're like me, you've probably accumulated a ton of apps over the years that you rarely use. But here's the thing. Every app is a potential point of entry for an attacker, or in some cases, might even be a fraudulent app hiding a more sinister purpose. Go through your app list and remove anything you don't use on a weekly basis. Pay attention to apps that you especially don't recognize. If there's anything unfamiliar, do a quick Google search to verify what it is and whether or not it's safe. Some malicious apps disguise themselves as harmless utilities or even security tools, so don't take any chances. At this point, app downloads are really so easy that the idea that you might use an app at some point in the future, therefore I have to keep it on my phone, it's not a good enough reason to hold on to it. Delete it and move on. Also, be aware of apps that ask for way more permissions than they need. Does LinkedIn really need access to your location data? Probably not. These requests are red flags to me. Unless you absolutely need it, delete the apps. Of course, there are plenty of other things to consider in order to do a thorough review of your phone. I've listed many of them out in this free mobile scan checklist that you can download, but I'll share a few of them here as quick bullet points. Make sure your OS and all apps are updated. Change your phone passcode. Turn on advanced data protection to encrypt all of your backup data. Review all camera and microphone permissions. Do a safety check to make sure you know exactly who you're sharing your information with. In extreme cases where you suspect you're being actively targeted, turning on lockdown mode is advised. Check for an unknown alternate appearance for Face ID. If all else fails and you're still concerned that your phone has been compromised, the nuclear option is to do a full factory reset without restoring from a backup. I know this sounds extreme, but restoring from a backup can sometimes reintroduce the same malware and spyware that you're trying to get rid of. And before you hit that reset button though, make sure that you've transferred any important files, photos, data, or even 2FA codes from something like Google Authenticator to a secure location, not just through a backup method that could, again, reintroduce those infections. And once you're sure everything is backed up safely, go ahead and reset your phone to factory settings. This will wipe out everything, including any hidden malware that might be lurking in the system. That's it. Do you think I'm missing anything else? Leave it in the comments. Be sure to try Certo using the special discount code as part of this URL, and then go download that full checklist linked to in the description.